All right, guys, we're running late, so we gotta go. Bye. No.
Thank you so much. We're here.
No, hello. Good morning, everyone. We are at City of Hope again. And it is like 7 in the morning. We're so exhausted. Last night we went to Disneyland on a like whim because I completed my PET scan and we wanted to spend the evening at Disneyland. It was a lot of fun. Do I regret going late last night when we had to wake up at 5 in the morning? Yes.
No.
Yes. I do regret going. I wish I would have slept. No, I had fun with the family. It was Kyle, the kids, and my brother. We had fun. I'm terrified for today. I've got my port stuff set up. And I have blood work. Then I see my doctor. We hopefully go over PET scan results. And I have the infusion chairs scheduled because I might start a new line of treatment today, depending on what my doctor says. So we will see if I start a new treatment today, or if I stay on blue, the clinical trial, or if I go to nothing. He says I won't. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm scared. Take off your seatbelt. Stay a while. Is that what you say to Ellis?
I said to Ellis. Come on, man. Take off your shoes. Stay a while. Where's the shoes in the house? I'm sick to my stomach.
Oh, yeah.
So sick to my stomach.
It's because he ate cinnamon sugar donuts at Disneyland last night. He had like 2 packs, him and my brother. They love them. At Daisy's Cafe, they're like accidentally vegan. They're really good. They taste like little churro donuts.
They're good.
Him and Michael went nuts on
them. That could be part of it, but the other half is just not knowing.
Oh, yeah.
What is happening today.
Yeah.
That's okay.
That's okay, yeah. Last night he was like, what's getting to you? And I said, the fact that I don't know what's happening on this journey even tomorrow. He's like, is that like figuratively or actually you don't know what's happening tomorrow? I said, no, actually I don't know what's happening tomorrow. But TMI, you guys know I give too much information. Here it is. I have never struggled with constipation until battling cancer. The medications give me constipation. And if you battle cancer, you know, it's like constipation, diarrhea, constipation, diarrhea, constipation, diarrhea. And I haven't struggled with constipation in a while. But since my thoracentesis, I've had extra pain meds that I've been taking. And then on Monday for the PET scan, I had extra medication, pain meds that I was taking. So I'm constipated today, but I have diarrhea at the same time. Have you guys ever had that? It's where you have to rush to the toilet because you have diarrhea, but it won't come out because you're constipated. That's what I had this morning, and it didn't come out, and a little bit, but sorry, it's so gross, I'm sorry.
I've never had that.
But that's just the battle of cancer treatment. And I've struggled with diarrhea my whole life, but never constipation. Have you struggled with constipation? It is no fun. I didn't realize how bad it was. Being someone who struggled with diarrhea growing up, I used to think, oh, constipation's probably better than diarrhea but no, I don't like it. I think I prefer diarrhea, even though I don't like diarrhea. I can't with my conversations. This is like me reading the PET scan results, you guys, or the PET scan rules. There's another mockingbird, Kyle. Mm. It's like mockingbird season. We're seeing lots of mockingbirds. We're seeing lots of grasshoppers. And Kyle told me they're not native to our area. Hello! Oh, he came to say hi.
He's cute.
Oh. But there's lots of grasshoppers in our area and they're not local to our area. He said that
they move in like packs. I don't know what you call a group of them, but
yeah, I don't know what a group
like
of
locusts. And
don't say that.
they have decided to make this area of Southern California their home for however long, and then they moved to the next place. This was me talking to the very kind woman at the nursery.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh.
On Mother's Day?
On Mother's Day, yeah. And she told me that they are a pain for plants.
Oh.
And so they're having a rough time trying to keep them away. And they see them everywhere now.
Yeah.
Ladybugs.
Lots of ladybugs. Is that it?
I heard an owl last night.
Well, he had a cool truck bed. He pulled the handle of his truck bed.
Yeah, those are the new
ones.
And
it just slowly lowered. He let go.
That's cool.
That's cool. Kyle used to have a truck when we were first friends and when we first dated. It was a big white Toyota Tundra, mm-hmm. and his grandparents bought it for him because they wanted him safe on the road. So if he got in a car accident, he was in a big giant tank. And, oh, I loved that truck. It makes me think of you and how cute you are.
Okay.
Or cute you were back then.
It's good that I had it because I got in a lot of fender benders.
You were fine. They were tiny fender benders.
I was a bad driver when I was young.
Probably because you were in a giant tank.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
You know, if you're a person who speeds, I heard a statistic the other day.
I saw a thing about speeding the other day.
If someone is going the speed limit 65 or 70 on the freeway, and the next person over here is going 90 or 100, if they're going to the same destination, the person who's going 90 or 100 is going to get there probably 3 to 4 minutes ahead of the person going 60 to 70, based on math. And you're like 10 times more likely to get into an accident or get a ticket.
Or die in an accident.
Sit on speed.
Are you still offended that the Tesla was...
Yeah, there's a guy speeding behind me the whole time. And there's traffic in front of me. Where am I supposed to go? And then
We were stuck in the carpool lane. So we couldn't like switch lanes to be polite. We were stuck. It was a double white.
It wasn't even that. There was traffic in front of me. Where does he want me to go?
And then Kyle finally was able to exit the lane. And the dude laid on the horn like we're too slow. But there was literally traffic the whole time. And then we passed him when we exited.
You know,
he was stuck. He zoomed past and then he was stuck in a big line again.
So just don't speed. It doesn't get you anywhere. Like, come on.
I saw a thing on Instagram Reels where you think it's cool, young teen boys or young adult boys, to race. Mm. And it's cool until mom gets the call. And it was like a real call of mom getting the call that her son died from racing, street racing. So don't speed. Don't race, guys.
It's not worth
it. Your place will be there. And if you miss the appointment or whatever it is, life's too short to worry about it.
Yeah.
Reschedule.
You can always be late. It's fine.
We're so weird. Clearly we're stressed, you guys.
Yeah, we gotta go.
He's doing the PET scan rules with me.
Man, we gotta go.
Okay, we gotta go. Oh, wish us luck. Pray
for
us.
See you on the flip side.
Do whatever you do, and we'll let you know what we're doing. All right, love you guys. Bye. I decided to not look cute in any way, shape, or form today because I was tired and grouchy this morning. I wasn't grouchy.
No.
I just didn't want to get up to come here. No offense. I now have my port hooked up. It's like the old chemo days where they leave it in for infusion. We'll see. We are waiting in the room for my doctor, and this waiting time is torture. Not that they're taking too long, but that our anxiety is building, waiting for the news, whatever it is. Ooh. What's going on there?
Here she comes to wreck the day. Yeah.
So loud for anyone wearing headphones. Who's coming to wreck the day?
It's from a movie. I don't.
Is it me?
No, it's just, it was in my.
Guys, is that directed towards me?
No, the cancer. The, you know.
The cancer? My phone ran out of room again.
That's a camera.
Huh?
You said phone.
My camera ran out of room again. Because I filmed too much. But I film too much because I have stage 4 cancer and I want my kids to be able to watch mama.
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 If you're wondering why we're not talking about the results, it's because we are scared. We are scared. And we're partially excited because we don't have to stay here today.
Today feels like a minimum day. I was scheduled for the infusion chair. You guys saw my port hookup. And they said, oh, not today. Not today. I will be starting a new treatment next weekend. The verdict is in. Blue. Clinical trial. Blue. Stopped working for me.
We're done. Moving on from that one.
I'm sad.
Yeah, those are always traumatic conversations. Done with this, moving on to something new.
It was giving me really good quality of life. I liked that it was a pill to where I didn't have to come in for infusions.
Yeah.
It's less toxic than other things.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm bummed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So clinical trial is done. Where do we go from here?
Well, you want to talk because I can't.
Yeah.
I can't think.
Like I always say, nothing is set in stone until it's 100% set in stone, as our doctor likes to say. So the tentative plan is to start a new treatment next week. And it didn't sound like it's a chemotherapy. It's a targeted therapy. There were a couple names floated out there, but we won't know for sure until our doctor is continuing to gather all the evidence from PET scan, from multiple tests, the tissue tumor test. There's a whole bunch of stuff that he still wanted to keep gathering until he makes the 100% final decision. But sounds like targeted therapy. Sounds like it's through an IV. So you would have scheduled infusions. But it wouldn't be chemotherapy, it would be targeted therapy, which sounds good. This one is specifically for your gene mutation, so that's exciting. And we just kind of go from there. The PET scan results came in, of course, and...
We haven't looked at them on paper yet.
No, just based on our doctors, they were both pretty just like neutral positive about it. Nothing crazy lit up on the PET scan. Just the fluid that we already knew about.
No tumor explosion.
No major organs. They said it looks like the fluid and maybe a couple lymph nodes, but nothing crazy.
It's just my left lung area.
Yeah.
It's right?
Yeah. But even there, it didn't even sound like there was much alive in the lung.
Yeah, it wasn't much.
It's just the fluid. So.
And some lymph nodes.
Blue was doing something for sure.
Just not enough,
it seems. And they don't want to waste time and then wait for things to get worse. And then, oops, we waited too long. So I think that's why they're... I don't want to speak for them, but I think that's why they're jumping to something different. So it's a bummer every time we have to cross something off the list.
Can I give my bad news?
No.
Why?
No.
I have to tell them what's going on.
Oh, yeah.
What are you thinking?
I got it.
I thought
you were going to say, like, this is the worst.
No, he thinks I'm a Debbie Downer. I have to get a catheter. Boo. For those of you that don't know, I have a pleural effusion, so I have lots of fluid in my left lining of my lung.
You guys know how
that works. I mean, if you don't know how it works, Google it. But basically, when you're getting it drained as much as I am, and it already feels like it's increasing again, we've come to the conclusion, my doctor's come to the conclusion, that I need the catheter. I say this is bad news because I have pain when it's drained, so if I'm having it drained constantly, I'm afraid I'm going to be in pain always. So my team is taking that into consideration with every decision they make, and they are trying to make something cater to me to where it's less painful and whatever. But if we do it and it is excruciating, we just have to like cross that bridge when we get there and figure out what works, what doesn't work. But they're being very cautious. They know that my body is sensitive to everything so far that we have done. So they understand that, and they are trying to come up with the best ways to help me out. I know someone here who has the catheter, and she says it's fine and no pain. So I'm hoping it can be like her. But so far it seems like my body just doesn't like the fluid draining. So we'll see. That will be in my ribs here. I will have a little tube that comes out so we can drain it. And they'll teach us how to drain it at home, I'm assuming Kyle and my sister will be the drainers. They'll help me. My sister's a nurse, and Kyle is my DIY nurse.
That's right.
Do-it-yourself nurse.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, how do I feel? Happy. Why? Because I get to go home and see Winningy.
Short term. We're thinking short term.
Yes. We have to live in the present with cancer. And so right now, I don't have to go sit in the infusion chair and get loaded with toxins. So I'm happy. I get to go pick up my daughter early from being babysat. And I get to pick up Ellis from school with my honey bunny.
We all get to pick up Ellis.
I think we should take Winnie to lunch.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited to go home. And is there anything else I'm missing? We met someone there that's...
A viewer.
Watches. It was nice seeing you. I hope you're doing well. She was very nice. And my dad's texting. He must not have gotten my call.
Mm-mm.
Is there anything I'm forgetting?
Catheter. New treatment. PET scan was okay.
He changed her outfit.
She probably begged for that when she woke up.
She's been wanting that.
Wow, thanks, Pops. That was nice of him.
Pops changed Winnie into a cute dress she's been wanting to wear. But he doesn't know how to do hair yet. So here's this picture he sent us of my dad and Winnie at Nectar.
Look how happy she looks with her little smoothie.
She wanted that dress so bad. That was one of the hand-me-down dresses from my mom's friend. She loves it all.
She's been pointing it out every day. I feel bad I haven't put it on her.
I told her no for Disneyland.
Yeah, it's too much.
Or no for...
Something.
I don't know what it was. Okay. Anything else?
Sure. I'm proud of you.
Thank you so much.
We lose our clinical trial nurse. Which is a bummer. She was great.
Not yet.
We still have her because you have to do like closing activities for your trial.
Yeah, so I'm gonna have a lot going on.
Well, yeah, there's a lot of appointments upcoming, and thank the good Lord up above that my school year's almost over, because it sounds like it's about to get
crazy
with your schedule.
Crazy.
So thank goodness for that. But clinical trial done. New treatment. PET scan okay. Sure. And catheter, soon to be. Yes. But we get to go home today. Minimum day, so let's go.
Minimum day. Yay. Let's go see Winnie and Ellis.
Bye now.
Bye now. Y'all take care now, you hear?
Bye now.
And there was a dog in City of Hope. Cutest little dog. And I waved at it. Kind of a young pup. And it looked at me like he couldn't figure out if we were at the vet or the human vet. He wasn't sure, so he wasn't enthused.
Someone else is waiting.
Oops. People are waiting for a spot.
But we feel
sorry like about that, tired. Guys. We
sit. They're waiting for this one. That's okay.
We sit and digress. No, is that the word? We sit and.
This is our place where we can.
We release.
Chat.
Yeah, we get it all out. Before getting on the road, we like to feel the feelings and then get on the road. I feel like that's a little safer, right?
I think so.
All right.
All right, call your dad.
Winnie styled herself for today. Pops got her ready, and Winnie, you look gorgeous. What a cute look.
I even did her hair, can you tell?
Yeah.
I was afraid to redo these, so I left them as is.
Looks good, Winnie. Gorgeous. We changed our restaurant because there was a field trip at the other restaurant, and we thought that would make the service very slow.
Hi, how are you guys?
Dad's here with us.
Hi.
day is done. We just finished dinner, which was so kindly made for us by one of the mom friends we made in Ellis's class. We loved it. Thank you so much. And I'm wearing my cute shirt that my sister and brother-in-law made for us for the lung cancer walk. Anyways, we are so grateful for dinner. It was so sweet of her to leave us dinner, especially on a day like today. We are so in our heads just thinking. And I've sat with the thoughts of everything for some hours now, and I'm feeling a little down. I'm feeling a little anxious, but it's okay. Still hopeful and positive. I'm just scared. You guys know when I get the fluid drained, my body doesn't like it and it freaks out, and we can't quite find the right medication that shuts off the pain. We've tried so many and they help a little, but it not much shuts it off, so we have to keep trying. I will stay on the clinical trial medication until we start my next treatment, which is a little bummer for me. I get it. I like that I will be staying on a treatment the full time. Like, I'll always be on treatment. But if the idea of a week off of treatment sounded nice, maybe I wouldn't feel as sick. Or my new side effect, I'm getting a lot of white hair from the clinical trial, and it's even going into my eyebrows, my eyelashes, and other places. But I'm glad that will be stopping soon, because I don't want all the white hair. I love white hair. I think it's beautiful, but I don't like it from treatment, if you know what I mean. I'll wait till nature wants to do it. That's when I would rather have it. But that will be done next week. And I'm nervous to start a new treatment. When I started immunotherapy in 2021, I was hospitalized for 15 days because my body hated it. And instead of the treatment trying to kill the cancer, it had my body or my immune system trying to kill me. So I don't look forward to trying a new treatment. I get scared every time. So prayers that my body reacts well would be greatly appreciated. And I'm just gonna be hopeful that it'll all go well. I can feel the fluid building up a little more already, which is not good, which confirms that I do need to get a catheter. I'm just nervous because you guys know it hurts me, and hopefully we can figure out a pain system. I think I'm gonna have pain before we figure out whatever works, but I'm okay with that because I understand how it works. And I'm already talking with my team about it, and we're trying to figure out what to do, how to do it. I don't know, it's just a lot to think about. I'm nervous, I'm stressed, I'm anxious, but I'm also hopeful. We talked with the kids about it and they didn't seem to care much. They don't really get it. And that's good. I'm glad they don't really get it. I'm glad that the news of it stopping working was not as bad as it could have been, like cancer in other organs, cancer just going nuts, more tumors. That would have been really bad. I'm glad it's just this small little spread that we can take care of. My team still seems hopeful. They're always the best. So I guess we just hope and pray and see what's gonna happen. Alright, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna sign off so I can edit and go to bed. I will see you guys soon. I don't know when, but I'll see you guys soon. And I hope you're doing well. I hope you had a good day today. And I love and appreciate you all. Bye.